What's up? It is the Chinchilla Notebook here and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be doing a video on what chinchilla fur rings are. I'm going to be talking about the symptoms, the treatment, and the care and all that kind of stuff. So I actually didn't really know a lot about fur rings because I just knew that I had to check my chinchillas for them. I never knew what to do if I ever got fur rings. That being said, I've never actually had to deal with those with my chinchilla Merlin or this little guy. Because it's just never been an issue. I don't know why. I'm thankful it hasn't, but basically I thought I would do more research into it because I think that it's something that everyone should be aware of if they have a male chinchilla. Sorry, he keeps running everywhere. I'll try to get him on camera, but anyway, so I did some research and I did look into credible sources, so I made sure that I got my information from a good source, from certified veterinarians. Alright guys, so first off, I'm going to get into the definition of a fur ring. A hair ring consists of loose fur that becomes trapped on the sheath of a chinchilla's penis. When the penis retracts itself, the fur rolls up, forming a tight ring of knotted fur that encircles the penis, causing discomfort to your chinchilla and leading to potential health problems. So that is what it is. I will try to put some pictures on the screen where you can see what a fur ring is and some examples of what happens when it gets really bad. It only happens to males. And if you don't have a male chinchilla, you won't ever have to worry about this. If you do, you're gonna have to check for fur rings regularly in every health check that you do, hopefully weekly. So some symptoms include, sorry, he keeps running away. I don't know how to get him on camera. Oh my goodness, he just hurt himself. All right, so symptoms include excessive grooming in the genital area, visible swelling around the area, discharge, inability to retract penis, and vocalizing when trying to urinate. So I'm sure if you've ever had a male before, you might have seen your chinchilla doing something a little bit interesting, and that is called grooming the area down there. So that is normal and healthy. It's not weird. However, if you notice your chinchilla is always messing around trying to groom down there and you see some white or yellow discharge, that's not normal. Also, if you notice that your chinchilla makes noises when they're trying to urinate, that's not good. It's a sign that they're having difficulty down there. So those are the symptoms, and what can happen is if the fur ring stays on and goes untreated, they won't be able to urinate and can develop serious health problems. So hair rings are definitely something to take seriously if you notice. And the way to check for a hair ring, I have done it in a health check in the past. I will link that video down below, how to do health checks on chinchillas. So you guys can check that video out to see how to do one. You basically just want to lift your chinchilla up and look down in that area. It's important to know what you're looking for as well, so I will include pictures of what is a normal chinchilla, a male chinchilla down there, and then what is a fur ring. All right, so let's get into the treatment. First of all, you wanna take your chinchilla to the vet because a vet is gonna show you how to do it. They're gonna remove it for you and show you how to do it. It is possible to remove a fur ring on your own chinchilla if the case is mild, and as long as you know what you're doing. You're definitely gonna need two people to do this, but basically what a vet does is they just use their fingers and a pair of tweezers to gently loosen the fur, like the fur ring, until it comes off. And like I said, if it depends on how irritated and how bad the fur ring is. If there's infection, irritation, swelling, and it's really bad, if the penis is like not able to retract inside, you definitely need to see a vet. And it's not good for your chinchilla. And so that's how they remove it. It seems pretty simple, and it is, but it is a lot more difficult because you got a squirming chinchilla, you got a chinchilla in pain, you're dealing in a sensitive spot on their bodies. They're not gonna like it. So it's best to go to a vet first and see how they do it, just so that you know how to deal with it in the future. And in the few days that follow of the removal of the fur ring, if you notice swelling and irritation, that's normal. However, if it doesn't go away after a few days, you might want to go back to the vet to check for infection. And hair rings are serious, you guys. The risks if they go untreated are bladder damage, urinary tract infections, kidney problems, tissue damage, and in some extreme cases, even blood poisoning and the loss of the penis. And that's not what you want for your chinchilla. That sounds like a lot of pain, and it could potentially lead to a lot of serious health problems. Very important if you have a male chinchilla to be checking for hair rings. Like I said, I've always checked for them. I've just never had one on any of my chinchillas, so I've never had to deal with it before. But it is very vital that you deal with it if you do see it on your chinchillas, and that you take care of that, because it's just part of owning a male chinchilla, and it can happen. It doesn't happen too often, but it can happen on certain chinchillas more than others. just depends on their grooming habits, how their fur bunches up. My advice to you, like I said, if you ever experience a fur ring, is to try to go to a vet before you do it on yourself, like do it with your own hands, because vets are experienced, and if you've never dealt with a hair ring before, it can be very difficult to try to learn it. So I would just watch how the vet does it. They'll give you their own tips and stuff. And if they advise you to try it, if it ever happens again, then you can. But like I said, fur rings are very serious. I would go to the vet to get that looked at and taken care of. And it is possible to do it on your by yourself, but you just have to know how to do it without hurting your chinchilla. So anyway, I hope this video just gave you guys a little bit more insight and awareness of fur rings on your male chinchillas. Like I said, it's very important that you're watching out for these and you're dealing with them appropriately. So that is it for the video. I'm sorry, this little guy literally hates the camera. He's not like Merlin. Merlin's a sucker for the camera. But I will see you guys in the next video.